Hey everyone, my name is Aditya and I'm a developer advocate here at Salesforce. In this quick take, we are going to see how you can create components dynamically using Lightning Web Components open source. A quick disclaimer, this ability to create components dynamically is not available currently on the Salesforce platform. So you can only do this off platform using Lightning Web Components open source. Let's dive in. Let's start with a fundamental question. Why should I create components dynamically? The reason to create components dynamically is because it improves performance of your apps, because it reduces the static or hard dependencies between components. Hard dependencies essentially become a part of your components bundle or dependency tree, which increases the size of the component, which means it takes more time to fetch the component from the server and load it. Let's see it in action. Here, we have a use case where we've built a wizard with four steps that are shown one after the other. If you take a look at the code behind it, you'll see that there are four components, one for each step, which are conditionally hidden and shown using JavaScript code and custom events. I've oversimplified things for this demo, but the components for each of these steps can be fundamentally different with different implementations and can have huge subtrees. Even though all of these components are not shown in the UI, for example, there is only one step that is shown at a time. The app component explicitly depends on step 1, step 2, step 3, and step 4 components. And hence, they'll all be a part of the definition or the dependency tree for the component, which, like I said, increases the component size, which is undesirable for performance. Now, this is what I mean when I say static or hard dependencies. Now, let's imagine if you have a lot of such components for different steps. Then the code becomes really verbose because you are going to put a lot of conditional statements, which in turn is going to make your component very bulky. Dynamically creating these components make these dependencies soft, meaning that the components will only be loaded on demand during runtime. However, it is important to remember one thing. Even though the components are created dynamically, the reference to those components has to be statically verifiable during compile time. The reason for that is that a dependency should never be discovered or learned for the first time during runtime. Now, why are we doing this? We are doing this to prevent you from trying to load a component that doesn't exist. And we'll see what it means in just a bit. Now let's see the same example that I've shown you, but instead of static dependencies, the components are now going to be loaded dynamically. I've created a new component called Dynamic App so that I can show you how the app component and dynamic component vary. So all of this conditional logic from the app component can now be replaced with just one line of code in the dynamic app component. Now, this one line of code has two parts. First, the LWC Dynamic Directive. The value for this directive is going to be the constructor of the component that we want to load. Second, the HTML tag that we have used. It need not really correspond to any existing component. So if you look at the source code, you can see that there is no component called dynamic steps, but even then I've used the tag name. So a tag name can literally be anything that you want, but it's important that you use your own namespace. So that is why here I've used the namespace mine. The constructor value for this directive is going to come from the JavaScript file. In the JavaScript file, you can see that we've used the import statement in order to import the component. And once the component is imported, I'm assigning its constructor to the property that is used by LWC directive. I can import the component in a lifecycle hook or in response to events or any other function that I want. In this example, I'm loading step 1 dynamically during component load, and the other steps are loaded in response to custom events. Now during compile time, LWC checks whether or not a component with the name step 1, 2, 3, and 4 are present in the my namespace or not. If not, it's going to throw a compile time error. And this is what we mean when we say a reference has to be statically verifiable. So the component itself is imported and loaded during runtime, but during compile time, we just want to check if the reference is valid or not. And what this means is that you cannot pass variables to this import statement. The import statement should always have a static hard-coded string. You can also pass data to these dynamically created components and handle events from them, all using the same tag that we have defined. So along with the LWC Dynamic Directive, I can use attributes to pass values to the components and also attach event handlers. So now that I've defined my dynamic component, let me now change the component that is bootstrapped in index.js from app to dynamic app. So now if you look at the output, it works just the same. But let's look at how performance is impacted. For that, let's revert to using the old app component, which has hard dependencies. And one thing, by the way, I want to call your attention to is that to mimic a large component size, I've used a base64 data URI for the image in step 4. Ideally, you shouldn't do this because you can just use a URL. But just to mimic a huge component, I've done this. Now I'll run the build script to bundle the code for production. Once the script is complete, notice that in the distribution folder, you can see just one huge app.js file because all the dependencies are hard and are bundled together to be loaded on the page. Now let's run the serve script to look at the output. Now in the network tab, notice that we are getting the app.js file, which is almost close to an MB. This is an overhead because during page load, we are showing only one component, but we are loading the bundle for all the components. So now when I switch to dynamic app and run the same build command, notice that you'll see different app.js files in the distribution folder. So each soft dependency got bundled into a different file, which can then be fetched and loaded on demand only if necessary. So let's run the serve command again to look at this output. Notice that it loads only two files during page load, each of which is very small in size. Maybe one file just loads the LWC framework and the other loads the step one component. But now notice, as I advance through the steps, new requests are made to fetch additional components. And each of their size is also manageable. So what you're doing here is you're only fetching the components that you need, thereby improving the performance of your apps. Check out the GitHub repo linked in the description for the code samples that I've used today. Thank you for watching. If you've learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and click that bell icon to get notifications.